Sophia here. Just a little sad today because I was walking outside and it was raining the other day and I was not paying attention and I had my brand new white Converse on and there was a huge puddle of mud and I didn't see it and then I stepped right in it so my brand new white shoes got all muddy and now they're a different color and they're all dirty and I'm really sad about it because I really like my shoes. But I heard that today we're talking about sadness and overcoming sadness, so I thought I'd show up and just listen to what we have going on today. So if you're sad about something too, I know this will probably help us out, so let's go.
Welcome to Explore Bootcamp. It's Sergeant Iris T. London again, and my cadets, give it up for them. Yeah. Listen, team, are you all ready? We're overcoming sadness today with joy. Anytime you're honest with God, that's where true joy comes. You don't have to be fake with God. Just, He can handle it. Anything that you're dealing with, He can handle it. So are you ready to overcome with joy today? All right, so we're just gonna start out with some arm pumps. Going up and down, legs wide, ready? Let's go, push it. Knees are soft, come on. We're victorious. Come on, champ. Keep the chest lifted. Let me see those muscles. Ah! Come on, let's go. Uh-huh, come on. Keep it going. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, I like it. We're going to that shuffle. Are you all ready? This is what a shuffle looks like. Pull that navel to spine. Are you ready to run it? Let's go. Come on. We will not be sad. We're going to be happy, baby. Team, are you happy?
Yeah.
Are you happy? He doesn't look happy, but I think he is. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, shake it off. Next, we're going to knee taps, working at 4. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's go. Come on. Get it up. You can hot put it if you want to. Let me see that core work. Come on. We're getting rid of sadness. Any negativity. Get rid of it. Come on. Woo! Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2. Tap it out. Y'all ready? Last round. We have jump squats. We are squatting on all sides. Ready? 3, 2. Let's go. Stay light on those feet. Push. Come on, team. We will not be sad. We will be happy. We're pouncing our sadness. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2. You did it.
Hello, friends. Welcome back. It is Captain Courage here, and today I am going to be teaching you a valuable life lesson. So, as you saw last week, I was headed towards the mountains because I needed to get a signal on my phone. But while I was climbing the mountain, I kept tripping. Then I looked down and my shoelace was untied. So I thought, why not teach you all how to tie a shoe? I know you think it's simple, but it's a lot harder than it seems. So today, we are going to go over the basics on how to tie a shoe because I needed a reminder. And maybe some of you don't know how to tie, and now you will. So, here we go. Let's begin. So I have a shoe here. That's the first thing you need, of course. So second, you're going to take our laces like this and cross them over into an X. You see that? It's making a little X. Perfect. So then, we're going to bring this side down through the hole underneath, and we are going to pull so it makes a little knot. You see? I love knots. So there goes that. Then we're going to take one side, make a little bunny ear. See that right there? Perfect. And we're going to take the other side. We're going to wrap it around, and there's going to be a little hole right there in the middle. We're going to put that lace through, and we are going to pull both at the same time. And now we have a bow for the shoe, and I won't trip anymore. And if it comes undone, then I can just tie it again. There's also another way we can do this, so let me show you again. The first step is gonna be the same, get your shoe, then we're gonna take the laces again, make our X, cross underneath, perfect. Then we're going to make two bunnies. So one on this side, and one on this side. Now we're going to cross them over, make another X with the ears this time. There should be a hole in the middle. We're going to tuck it underneath, and we're going to pull, and there we have it. Another bow. So now you won't trip if your shoe comes untied. Love that. So now I'm gonna put my shoe back on, but before I go and continue to hike up this mountain to get a signal on my phone, I want to ask you a question. What is one thing that always brings you joy? I want you to think about that question and watch today's video and tell me at the end what that one thing is. Well, I'm headed off. Bye.
What's wrong, Susie?
There's no one on this island to talk to. I mean, besides you, you're great, but
thanks.
I miss my friends and my home and all of my toys.
Well, that sounds very reasonable. That's a good reason to be sad. But I have a verse from the Bible to encourage you.
Where?
It's from Nehemiah 8:10, and it says, "The joy of the Lord will make you strong." So I know you're sad, Susie, but Jesus lives on the inside of you. So we need to depend on him for joy, because he'll give it to us.
I guess you're right. God is great, and I can definitely have a lot of joy when I think about all the good things he's done for me.
Exactly, and we have each other, and we're gonna get off this island soon.
I sure hope so.
Oh yeah, me too. This is taking too long. But keep
that
on the-
Do you think God will send us ice cream?
Maybe. You can pray, did you ask?
I would love to.
How about you pray and ask him and we'll see what happens.
Okay.
Awesome.
Ah! Life Changers, kids. Battle Royale week 4. Weeping Rates. You see this? I don't know if you can tell, but it's pouring rain. You see the drips on my body? Listen, the Battle Royale stops for no one. No weather, nothing. So this week, we are going to get right into it, all right? This game is gonna be a very special one. We're gonna explain it all to you guys in 1 second. Let's get to it. Okay, Life Changers kids, this game's called Squirt Ball. Basically, we're gonna have 2 cones on each side, and your little team captains here are gonna have to squirt the ball from one cone to the other. Whoever gets there first is the winner. Now you're probably asking yourself, who is that right there? Well, he is your sub blue team. So, do you guys think here your sub can win? He's representing blue, but remember, if you are on red, orange, or green, make sure to cheer on your captains as well. This is gonna be a close game again. It's gonna be tournament style. So it's gonna be blue versus red first game, and then it's gonna be orange versus green. And whoever wins those two will go in the championship match. Let's go to game one. 3, 2, 1, go! Time for the championship round. We're doing blue against green. 3, 2, 1, go!
Ah. Ah. No!
Hey, what are you doing? Get out of here! Hey, never get away! Get out of here, leave, run away! Run! Here in the Battle Royale, we don't take sore losers. We only take winners. And green team, Your captain just won! Elijah, can you talk to us? What was going through your mind? How did you do so well? You did it so easily.
Well, I kind of just aimed for the top of the beach ball, and then from there, kind of just rolled. And once I did it the first time...
No! Hey, get out of here! Hey, get out! Sorry, what were you saying?
And once I did it the first time, it was kind of easy to do it the second time.
Wow. You see, he used his big mind and used momentum of the ball to keep it spinning and spinning and spinning. Elijah, you just gave the green team 50 points. And you know, I was gonna give blue team 25 points, but because of that guy over there, you guys get no points. I'm sorry, I don't make the rules up. What he did is unacceptable, but if you're a green team, you should be really happy right now. Elijah, great job. Green team, keep on cheering on. And if your team did not win, that is okay. Keep on posting. You can give your team points. You can make a difference. We'll see you guys the next week.
Go Green Team!
Joy?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, kids, why don't we listen to this song and worship together? Let's go.
Though the tears may fall, my song will rise. My song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise. My song will rise to you. While there's breath in my lungs, I will praise you, Lord.
Was that worship song, just to remember that the joy of the Lord is our strength. And I want to give you the opportunity right now, if you're watching, to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. All you have to do is repeat this simple prayer. So go ahead and close your eyes, bow your heads, and repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Lord, I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth that you are Lord. I believe that you rose from the grave 3 days later so that I can live eternally with you. I thank you and I receive you into my heart. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen, amen. Guys, that's the best decision that you'll ever make. Receiving him into your heart, you will have so much joy from here and on out. It's going to be the best life that you will ever live. And also, if you pray that prayer for the very first time, visit us on lifechangerschurch.com/growinyourfaith. We have a gift that we want to send to you. We have a card that will teach you all about your next steps in growing in your faith with Jesus. I hope you guys are enjoying this service, but let's get ready to go check out Challenges with Dre and Romy. Let's go.
What's up, guys? It's Roman, aka Romy, and this is
Andre, aka Dre.
And today, we are doing what's called Guess That Soda Challenge. Right here, we have 5 different cups of lemon/lime sodas, and we have to guess which one is in it.
So right now, we have 5 different sodas. We have Sprite, Ginger Ale, Mountain Dew, 7-Up, and Squirt. Okay, now we're gonna get into our first round.
I know what it is.
Okay.
It's very green.
It's very green?
Yeah.
How can you tell it's green by tasting it?
I just know it's green. I know it's green, guys.
You know a drink is green when you taste it?
Yeah.
All right. Ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Ginger ale.
That's correct.
I won.
What? All right, guys. We're going to get into the next cup right now.
This one has more of a bittery.
Yeah, I definitely. It's not that fizzy.
Yeah. This is.
I don't know if I've ever had this before.
Okay,
here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Squirt.
That's correct.
Hey, all right, Romy's doing a lot better than he's been doing in past rounds. I'm impressed. Okay, so now let's go into round 3.
Very sugary. This is even more sweet.
Yeah, and it's like the carbonation is almost going like down and down and down as we're going in. But I think I know what this is. What about you, Romy?
I know it.
Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Mountain Dew.
That's correct.
Jeez. Romy's been, you know, he's in his head, he's in the game right now. He is, you know, alive and well today. I don't know what it is, but I guess he's just doing a lot better this round. Let's go into the next round.
Very plain and tastes very white.
Tastes very white?
Yep.
Wow.
This one tasted green. This one tasted white. I know it.
I know my answer. I think I'm good.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Lemon lime.
What?
Both of those answers were incorrect.
Ooh. Comes down to this last cup then.
Dang!
Let's get into the final round then. This is gonna be interesting. This is a tiebreaker right here.
Let's get it. Definitely sweeter.
Sweeter? You think?
And more yellow.
Yellow.
And
I
tasted the yellow one.
I'm lost on how you can find these colors, but I'm impressed.
I just know.
All right, I think we're ready.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Sprite.
7-Up was the answer.
Alright guys, once again Dre wins, but Romy, he put up such a great fight. I'm be honest, I'm impressed. Compared to his last two performances, this performance was definitely up there, guys. So who knows, maybe as it goes on he's gonna get better and better. I don't know if he's ever gonna take a dub, to be honest, just because I'm like at a GOAT status right now, guys. But we hope you guys enjoyed this challenge. Make sure you guys comment any challenges, suggestions that you might have for us. We're open to do other challenges, but let's just go ahead and get on to the next thing.
Are you sure about this? I could have climbed the tree myself.
It's okay. I was a Girl Scout in middle school. Climbing trees is nothing for me.
This isn't the only way to find Jaden, you know.
Yeah, I know, but it's the easiest. From up here, I can possibly get a full view of the island.
Please don't fall. We don't know where the closest hospital is.
It's an island. There are no hospitals.
Wait, what did you guys say?
Nothing. You're doing good. Just be careful. Can you see anything?
Just trees. I'm gonna go up further.
What was that?
It sounded like a scream.
Oh no. What if Captain Courage is being attacked by a bear?
There's only one way to find out.
Hello?
Who are you?
We could ask you the same thing.
Wait, I know you. You're Kenny from the Kenny Show.
Yeah. You know who I am? You watch my show?
When I was younger.
Yeah.
Wait, how did you get here?
You know, that's a very personal question. You see, I was going to Florida with my family, but our boat crashed, and I don't know where they are now.
Have you checked anywhere else in the island?
Of course I have! I've been trying to look for my family for the past few days! You see, I went over there, but then a volcano erupted, so I came back here, and luckily, now I'm safe.
Well, yeah, we saw that eruption, too.
Well, did you try heading in that direction?
No! Come over here. Do you see that cliff? It's very scary and dangerous. You do not want to go over there. But, you know, anyway, I don't think I'll ever be able to host the Kenny Show with them.
Well, we're looking for a friend. Maybe we can help you find your family, too.
Wow! That's... No! There's no use! We're all trapped, and we're all doomed!
Kenny, we're not trapped. We just have to...
And now rain? Could this get any worse?
Is that what you wanted?
No. I want my family.
Well, that's not gonna help you.
Exactly.
You know, maybe we should have gotten Captain Courage to get help.
Oh no, Zena. Don't let Kenny get you down too.
Hey! I'm missing my family. What am I supposed to be, happy?
Well, if it were my family.
I'm getting really nervous. We've already lost Jaden. We might have to help Kenny find his family. We've been to this island for an entire day, and we have no clue where we are.
Well, don't say that. We're gonna find the treasure and go home just like we planned.
Right. Treasure?
We've been on this island for an entire day. We don't know where the treasure is, and we've already lost Jade.
Oh, stop. Wait, calm down, everyone. Treasure?
Yeah. I'm showing them around the island via a treasure hunt for a hidden treasure.
See, that's your guy. Just helping us find the treasure she hid.
Wow. Well, what kind of treasure is it?
Well, I can't tell you because that it would ruin the surprise for them.
Oh! Well, I guess I'll let you guys go back to your scavenger hunt, and I will just be here, sad, and alone.
Maybe you should check the beach. If you got shipwrecked, perhaps your family landed somewhere near the edge of the island while you landed here.
I did see a backpack and a purple suitcase there when we came here.
You did? Wait, does that mean they got washed up from the ocean?
Oh no, Kenny's family might be drowning. Jaden might have got eaten by bears. This island is such bad luck.
Guys, being so
gonna help us. Why don't we pray?
Pray? I'm too sad to pray.
That's exactly why we should. We can find joy when we are honest with God about our feelings. We can let go of our sadness by sharing it with God.
Well, is God gonna send us a helicopter to save us?
Hopefully, because we're about to get caught in a storm.
Besides, don't we have to be happy to pray? Why would God want to listen to us whine and complain?
Because he loves us, that's why. He wants to take away our troubles.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, I'm sure. There was a prophet named Elijah. He loved God, and so he killed many false prophets who were trying to lead people to worship idols and man-made gods. King Ahab saw what Elijah did, and he told his wife, Queen Jezebel. The queen sent a message to Elijah, promising that she would kill him.
Oh, well, I see why Elijah would be sad. He could have lost his life.
Well, did the queen find him?
Elijah ran away, and he eventually ended up at Mount Sinai, the mountain of God. He spoke to the Lord, telling him he was afraid, sad, and wasn't sure what to do.
And then, God sent a flood to wash away the queen and the royal family, right? I guess not.
Well, what did God do anyway?
God told Elijah to head to Damascus and find a new king for the countries of Israel and Aram. And so Elijah did just that.
Well, we're now looking for a king on this island.
Right.
Unless, you know, that king would help us find my grandpappy and your friend.
Elijah has someone coming after him. That's why he was sad. That's nothing like what we're going through.
Well, it may not be the same situation, but Elijah was experiencing the same emotions you're feeling right now. He was sad and he poured out his heart to God.
So let's say we pray and tell God how we feel. Then what?
Well, the story ends with God giving Elijah a purpose. Maybe that's why we're here. God has a reason for everything that's happening.
And what might that be?
I don't know. You're gonna have to ask him yourself.
Yes, it wouldn't hurt. Dear God, it's me, Zena. I thought coming to this island would be really fun. But we've lost Jaden, all our snacks, and we might have to help Penny find his family. I don't think it's such a good idea anymore.
And God, if you're still there, please help me find my pet lizard. He's been missing for a few days, and I miss him so much.
And Lord, it's getting here. Can you please help me find Susie and Grandpappy? I miss them. And please take us back to Florida so we can go to Key Lime Cove and the water slide. And Lord, could you also please give me an ice cream sundae with some sprinkles? Thank you.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
See, don't you feel better now?
Yeah.
I guess I do. I hope God can return Larry the Lizard back to me.
I do feel a little better knowing God has everything in control and everything will be alright.
Speaking of everything going alright, did you say you lost your grandfather?
Yes. I was traveling with my sister Susie and my grandpa Grandpappy. I just hope they're okay.
Well, I did see an old man and a girl on the beach yesterday when I was looking for Larry.
What? Really? What'd they look like?
The guy had a blue Hawaiian shirt and a beige hat, and the girl had a pink dress.
Oh, that is correct! That's them. I gotta get to the beach. How do I get to the beach?
Well, I can show you.
Thanks for telling us about that. I guess if Elijah can overcome the sadness, so can mine. I guess it was just a little hard being so far from home.
I understand. I've had my own doubts about this whole treasure hunt thing, especially after we lost Jaden. We owe it to him to at least find him, and then we can decide if we want to keep searching for the snickerdoodle treasure.
I think that's a good idea. I just hope he hasn't got swallowed by a swamp or covered in lava from the volcano.
Hey! Who's that?
Hey guys, I think I see Jaden.
Well, where is he?
It looks like he's at the bottom of a cliff, maybe 10 or so miles from us. There's a river nearby, so maybe he got washed away down there.
Uh-oh, it looks like he wandered into Shadow River.
Shadow River? What's that?
This island has three rivers, and Shadow River is the strongest flowing one out of all of them. Legend has it, the guy who discovered this island stopped to take a drink in that river, and it washed him away. His partner saw him, his shadow, and then
disappeared.
Well, what does that mean for Jaden?
Is he still alive?
I think so. It looks like he's building a fire.
Okay, well, that's a relief. I was beginning to get worried there for a moment.
Me too. Now we'll have our team all back together.
Hold my binoculars. I'm coming down.
Wow.
Wow.
That
my gosh.
Was crazy. The drama, like the story.
Exactly.
All of that. Talking about, like, obviously we're talking about joy this week. And,
right.
Like, how we can overcome our sadness. With joy. And like that drama, like they definitely were struggling.
They were. And I mean, like, I totally understand, because if I lost my friend on an island, I would definitely be sad.
100%.
And then, like, not only you lost your friend, but like you're away from home.
Right.
So yes, it's starting to finally get to them. And so of course they're feeling sad.
Like, can you imagine like being a young like kid and being stuck
on
an island?
Right.
Like, I'd be scared, I'd be sad,
exactly.
I'd be like,
all those emotions.
So,
it's
like,
terrible.
Yeah,
but
it's
then
wild.
Once they prayed and they brought all their sadness and their feelings to God, they were able to feel better.
Yeah, I thought that was really cool. And I think like that just like is so true though, because like even like in our lives, like whenever we're sad or whenever we're feeling down, and like you guys can do this too at home. Like if you're ever sad about something, you can always just pray to God, like let him know. Like just like in our big point today, it says it's okay to be sad as long as we tell Jesus about it. You guys can have that conversation by just praying a simple prayer and telling Jesus how you feel about it, and like it will bring all the joy in the world to you. So.
Right. And I know that when I feel sad or confused or like I'm not sure about what to do, praying always helps me, because then I can get everything I'm feeling out, give it to God, and then just let him take care of it.
Yeah.
So that always brings me 100%. Joy.
And just like even in the story of Elijah, how he was scared because of what was going to happen to his life.
Right? Jezebel was going to kill him.
Yeah,
she
like
was
that
coming
was
after him.
That's pretty scary. And like
right.
But what did he do? He ended up praying.
He did.
And he found like
God.
His purpose.
Right.
And once he realized his purpose, then like he was happy again.
Yeah.
Like, all that stuff didn't
matter.
So I think that's awesome. So you guys can have joy in every situation, no matter what it is. Whenever you guys are feeling sad, whenever the weeping rains are coming down your face, like all you guys have to do is pray, ask God for joy, let him know how you're feeling, and that joy will just come pouring right over you. So
Let's see next week if they find Jaden. He's still lost. I hope he's okay.
I hope so. Jaden's been missing for a while.
Exactly.
And like that tree.
Where is this kid?
Sheesh. I don't know, but we'll see what happens next week. But let's keep going on with the rest of this video.
Hey guys, it's me again, and I'm actually feeling a lot better after learning about the story of Elijah today. And I feel good knowing that it's okay to be sad as long as I tell Jesus about it, because when I do, then he'll help me out and help me move past it. But, oh, hey Ariana.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good. I heard you were sad, so I came to cheer you up.
Oh my gosh, you're so nice.
Yes, well, I heard what you said, and you are correct. The joy of the Lord will make you strong, and that verse is found in Nehemiah 8:10.
Right. I love that verse so much, because it reminds me that when I'm sad, I don't have to try and figure it out, because God is on the inside of me, and he's going to help me out. That's awesome.
So, before we go, I want you to repeat after me and say the can-do phrase for today. I can
find joy
when I am honest
with God
about my feelings.
I like that. Well, it's good to know that we can find joy and happiness when we give our feelings up to God, because he cares for us and he loves us. So thank you, Ariana, for the reminder. I appreciate it. And kids, if you're ever feeling sad, just remember that Jesus lives on the inside of you and he is there to help you. And you can be sad for a moment, but don't stay there. Give it to him and he will help you move forward. Well, we love you guys and we hope that you enjoyed today's video, and we will see you guys on Friday for a brand new Kids Connect. Bye.